I'm going to head to the guild hall, start scanning the book, and while it's scanning, I'm just going to throw darts at the target. Sorry, daggers.
All right. What else do people want to do?
Well, I'll go back to the guild, our guild hall as well, and put a, I guess a recruitment flyer up.
You're gonna make flyers?
Sure.
Okay.
Well, logically, what he said was sound, that we do need people.
I agree. I'm just making sure you're like, that you were going and making flyers.
Was the kitchen installed at this point, Marcus?
Well, when you come back, it's mostly installed. The chimney stack for the stove is technically not there, but it is there. As in, they're still planning to do the brickwork, so they'll probably finish it up the following day with putting brick around the exposed part outside. So it's usable. It's just the job isn't 100% yet.
Okay. Thought I would ask for a Venus egg.
Guys, look, I made more food. Avena, is this supposed to be green? No, it's supposed to be purple.
Wait, purple food? Rhubarb?
Exactly. No, just... That's the thing where you're like, what's it supposed to be? Huh. I don't know.
I don't know what that is.
Rhubarb or octopus?
Both.
You as a character or you as a person?
Well, I know what a rhubarb is as a person, and I know what an octopus is as a person. I've tried octopus. Didn't like it. Not too good.
I've had squid jerky.
Squid jerky's okay.
I could go for some rhubarb pie.
Rhubarb pie, yes. Oh my god. I guess you would know what a rhubarb is because of my natural terrain knowledge.
I don't know. Marcus, does rhubarb exist in this world?
Probably. If it's a normal food, I'd say it exists. If you were like, does the Palpo star fruit from Kingdom Hearts, maybe on a fucking island that you never get to go to, so this way you know this, but you will never get it, because
hey, Lan, can your true wish be to wish me to that island and back?
Nope.
The true wish, Tate, will be to wish you to the island. No back.
Or it'll just be he's there for a split second and then he's back.
Right.
The flowers will say, looking for like-minded adventurers, acquire inside for recruitment fee.
Recruitment fee?
Yes.
I'm sorry, recruitment fee? For what? What?
To join us.
Did I miss something?
No.
Apparently he's making flyers.
Yeah, making flyers.
The only reason I say recruitment fee is, remember how you're not supposed to have a fee?
Oh, I'm not? I forgot about that. Sorry, never mind. I'll just say inquire inside. Then, not a recruitment fee. I didn't realize there couldn't be a fee.
Guild rules.
I forgot.
Well, it's a lot more of it was a lot more Metweo and Octominos' rules, but there was going to be... or the rules were... Where the fuck are they?
Second page.
I don't know them, but Sepho, I don't know them, but my character does. He's read through both Guild Ball Daniels.
I was thinking as it more like a, you could, as like a logical thing, that if they wanted to join us, then they needed to prove that, prove their worth, more or
less.
Oh,
they they'd need to prove. Just to remind you, the guild's rules for them giving you basically a free guild and helping you out with different stuff was, your goal is like all the other guilds, which is to help the citizens of the world. Your guild is to have no price to join and stay, but just as easy it is to be added, it's easy to be removed. In other words, meaning you can join the guild and just be a cook, or just be a receptionist, or maybe all you do is you run mail.
Okay.
But you don't have to pay to stay.
Okay, I'll just have the flyer say, looking for light-minded adventures, acquire inside. Then.
And then the other big one was no killing each other. And then when you have a, you'll get called upon for a greater purpose and you have to answer the call.
Okay, I forgot that. Sorry about that, Marcus.
It's fine. I figured you forgot, so I want to remind you, like, I mean, you can, but they, you know, they might not be happy with you.
Okay, well, I'll just have the flyers state that looking for like-minded adventurers acquire inside on the flyers then. Just
okay. That. Now, Tate and Lam, do you guys want to use up your charges for the day?
Yeah, that's where my guy's going immediately after the meeting.
Okay. Again, keep in mind, you don't have to. The drive has been gone. It's just if you want to. I know Lam, for you, your character, Perthros, is like, oh man, I want to know what else the scene can do. Avena's, I don't know if she cares to know what her dice does or not. Maybe. She knows it's got given her items before, but...
Yeah.
And it summoned the fucking god... Or no, it didn't summon. Never mind. That was Lamb's one that summoned her,
I do need the thing. Lion Man Dwayne. After I fed him, you know, gemstone.
What about Lion Man? You gonna send him a text?
I was actually going to ask Akminos about that if at the end, but the mood didn't seem proper.
Sure. In terms of the new mood not being proper, Lam, keep in mind, Akminos is, if you were to look at his alignment, neutral. So...
Well, yeah, but my guy wasn't, like, in the mood to really ask something like that. Where gotcha. It's like, yeah, that's important, but I'm assuming he got it done if he's not mentioning it.
Alright, so real quickly, Tate, you check on your fucking rock.
Yep.
What are you checking?
Well, I fed him a gemstone, so I want to see how big he's gotten or what's going on.
Well, you take him out. And he looks normal, a little bigger, but on a couple little spots, you see what almost looks like maybe some sort of crystalline structure is forming. Like, it looks kind of shiny on spots. But it's not quite what you would call a crystal yet. If you think if you feed him more, maybe he'll actually start to sprout crystals.
Oh. Well, little V, you are looking just fabulous today.
And mind you, he's not a perfect circle. There's obvious bumps everywhere.
You are looking fabulous today. Is that a new haircut?
I don't have hair. Not like you.
Is that a new crystal cut?
I don't have crystals yet, but if you feed me more, then I'll tell you yes just to humor you.
Well, obviously I'm going to find you more. I want to see these crystals grow out. They look good on you.
You know what would look better and taste better?
Yes?
Magic crystals.
God damn it, I'm still not muted.
No, you're not, Lam.
I keep thinking I'm muting it, but apparently it's not actually clicking the damn button.
So what are you drinking, by the way?
Cocoa.
I was wondering. I'll keep an eye out for crystals or magic crystals. We'll see. For now, are you hungry?
I am. I don't know if you're going to be able to carry me much longer. You know what you could always do?
Request a crafter to craft a carrying basket.
I'm kind of being able to sense rocks a little bit. It's a weird feeling, but you know how there's this whole city?
Yeah.
I think we should go check out the Dwarven Mine area. I overheard them say it when I first got on in the city, and I'd never been there. But I bet it has a lot of rocks.
It probably does. I mean, we'd probably have to get maybe Eram to help us out with that.
No, you could just walk in.
Eram.
Come on. Let's just go. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Do it.
Eventually, I don't know the caves like Eram does. We'll have to get him. I assume Eram does.
Who's Eram?
You mean
Eram.
Kelb, can you pronounce your name for Tate?
Reem.
Reem, thank you. My head is tired.
Eram.
Reem.
I'm like, who says Eram? He's speaking up.
For the individuals that are going to stay at the guild hall, you want to go throw your little pieces on the map over there? So, like, Jared would be one. I know Demoises is already over there.
Indeed.
And then Perthros is obviously going to leave the city. I don't know about Noah, and I don't know about Tate.
I'm going to go with Perthros.
Okay.
Me and Perthros are doing one thing, wanted dice.
So you're going to tell them that you'll take them there later?
For now, I'm gonna probably give Little D a rock and put him back in.
Alright, you give him a rock, and you just hear, I want more!
We'll get you more later, I promise you. We'll stop by the mine.
He doesn't really say... Later. He doesn't really say much as you then put him away and give him that rock. You're pretty sure as you close the bag, you just see the smaller rock just go into him. Just kind of meld into him. You're not sure, but you could have swore that you saw it look like he just absorbed it.
Was it through a process similar to osmosis?
Yes.
I wonder if there's a flower out there like...
Is that a flower?
Yeah. I can name him, Mr. Heart, the flower. Captain Heart, and Dwayne the Rock. You remember Central Intelligence.
I'm gonna hit your piece around. Oh, there it flew.
Marcus, you can have this now.
Can one of you shrink this book for me?
Is that good?
It's a pixel at this moment, Jared. Did you want it bigger than that, or...?
Yeah, maybe a little bit bigger so it scales well to the guild hall table.
How's that?
There we go.
That's good, right? Well, with Tate holding it, we can't do shit about its size. Anyway. So Tate, Lamb, Noah, Perthros, Avena, and Tucson head on outside and travel out of the city and walk a good ways away to use their items.
Once storms come at this one.
Once you reach the same area, I assume, that you were at once before, go ahead and do your thing.
Concentrations. How many rolls? 3?
Yeah. If you're going to concentrate on each one, on each thing, Tate, it's 6. 1 for the bag and 1 for the dice. While they make their rolls, Kelb, what are you doing? You have Reem having a book on top of a book while throwing knives at a target. You have Demois at a table just drawing up flyers.
I'm at the doorway indicating that I'm not actually in the guild hall anymore and will be leaving to see about installing the forge again.
Are you going to move your targets and whatnot out of that spot since that's where you wanted it?
Yes, eventually.
Okay.
I mean, they could easily move upstairs
or this little side room on the first floor. I mean, or the side room on the second floor. It's no big hurt.
Upstairs.
Right, I mean, it's no big worry. But... Alright, yeah. So...
And Lamb has become evil. Got it.
If it's
what's
a 20...
stolen from me has finally come.
If it's a 20, Lamb, I'm just going to let you know now, you're going to want to use it carefully.
I know.
Because it has a year game-wise. Not real life. In-game-wise. Cooldown.
Well, it could... Could technically be a year real life.
It theoretically could, Tate, yes. Nevertheless. And do know, Lamb, it's not a anything.
Yeah, it's a limited wish.
Right.
Or it's a within reason wish.
It's a within reason. You want one of your stats to go up by 2 so that you can gain a +1, I suppose. That's a little OP, but whatever. You want to have a 30 across all attributes? Fuck off.
Was a 29 acceptable, Lamb? What? Would you think a 29
no.
acceptable for you, Lamb? What about 28, Marcus?
I was just hoping Lamb would be like, well, 29's not quite what I want, but I guess it'll have to do.
Is there a max technically to stats?
No.
No. The realistically, 30. I don't think anyone's ever gonna go above 30 unless they legitimately mid-max to try and go above it. and focused heavily on raising a certain attribute.
And by the way, I don't think a wish can improve total. I don't think a wish can improve a stat by more than plus 5.
No, I don't think so.
But yeah, that's
but basically being that this isn't the wish spell and it's something different, it's functioning like the wish spell. Nevertheless, we'll get to you guys in a minute. So Areem is gonna go head on out and go talk about the forge then. Is he just going back to the original place he went?
No, I'm going to see if there are other places.
Go ahead and roll a search for me then to try and find other places.
Kind of like a second opinion kind of thing. 6 to 8.
Do you remember what I told you initially?
Kind of. Let's see, did I actually write this down somewhere?
Was it 50, 200, 900? Something like that.
That sounds about right. It does not look like I wrote it down anywhere. Or if I did, the file did not save. Or get saved.
Alright, well, you find another one. Building looks a little more pristine. A little less craftsman and a little more businessy craftsman. I don't know how to word it.
Master craftsman?
Maybe. It seems almost a little too lavish. Kind of like comparing original Walmart store to current Walmart store, where it tries to be basic, but, well, no, I guess Walmart wouldn't work. It'd be like comparing trying to think of a place. It'd be like looking at a mom and pop hamburger shop and then looking at some sort of restaurant where it sells its hamburgers for 6 times as much, but you don't think it tastes all that much better.
But the cows were killed in place. You could hear them scream in the back.
That's, yeah. It's still mooing if you order it fresh. So yeah, you do find another place.
Okay, I shall enter and talk to whomever is at the, I'm gonna put this in air quotes, cash register.
Alright, you head on in, and there's plenty of items that are out on display, and there's a gentleman who is dressed relatively nice for being a smithy, or being a, craftsman? Carpenter? I don't know what the word would be.
I'll just go with craftsman. Craftsman sounds good.
So, yeah. He doesn't quite look like a craftsman.
Does he look like a salesman?
Yeah. I mean, a medieval salesman, but a salesman. Or relatively medieval. I mean, it's not really medieval, but whatever.
So he's not wearing like a $5,000 suit.
Right, he's not wearing a $5,000 suit, but he's definitely not wearing commoner clothes.
He's obviously wearing a 5,000 gold suit.
Right. Now, if you had to assume, you're pretty sure that his whole attire might have cost half of your building. So, he might charge a bit. Either he's really good and everyone goes to him, or he charges a bit.
I shall approach him if I haven't done so already at this point, considering I did say I was going to talk to whomever is at the cash register, and ask about his forge deals.
Ah, looking to install a forge, huh? Well, I have two packages. You either get the run-of-the-mill, but very, very elegant, or my supreme deal. Now, the supreme one versus the normal one will be set up with ergonomic hammers and... Hang on. Ergonomic hammers, and the coals actually burn longer due to how I have the air going through it. It takes a little longer for me to make, hence the higher price, but it's well worth it in the end. As for sturdiness, I mean, your building could probably fall on it and it won't fall apart.
And what are the prices of both packages?
Well, my basic package, you're looking at about 1,000 gold. The ultimate package, you're looking at about 10,000. 10 times the work, but 20 times the quality.
Was the name ever given to the other guy's place? Or to the other guy?
Probably, but I don't know if I have it written down.
That's also not just a question to you, Argus, but to anyone that may remember if he had been given the name.
Lethrian Garnett, or Lethrian Garnett General Contractor.
That's right.
Yep.
Oh no, he did the contracting. Honest Bob's Discount Forge and Metal. No, that was for.
Yeah,
that.
No, you were right.
So
the
yeah,
first time.
Yeah, General Contractor from Garnett.
Well, what do you say about Mr. Garnett's place then, Gamar Dior? So, like, what do you offer better than he does? I would assume he knows his own competition.
I decided, by the way, this guy is Tim, and he runs Tim's High Quality Contracting.
I'm doing what now?
Not you, lamb.
Do you mean Perthrus?
Or do you mean the guy from Home Improvement? Was that the show?
No, yeah. Not Tim Allen. Garnett? He takes too much of my business. Cuts his prices lower, but I hear and have seen that some of his work's a little more iffy. Besides, he doesn't even add any kind of embellishment. Throws a couple stones together and calls that a forge? Come on. Look at that. I even take the time to chisel in little animals and other such things into the stonework. It's all about the look. That's how you get the people to really take you serious. If you look fancy, they're gonna believe you do fancy.
Marcus, I assume you locked Lamb's D3 earlier. When you said good luck with that.
Yeah.
He just now asked me why it was locked.
I figured it was gonna be something like that, but I'm making sure it wasn't Kel trying to keep someone from fucking with it later. Yeah.
Do you see this floating dice over here, Marcus, by the way?
Marcus, you're an asshole. Fucking really? You can't just select them all at once.
Not when they're locked, Lamb. Not when they're locked.
Really?
Yeah, I can't select things that are locked.
Yeah, it sucks, nice. But it was worth it, damn it. Your D3
stuff to be arranged. Nice.
Your D3 is also unlocked again.
But yeah, I just wanted to. I like having my shit slightly organized. I'm weird.
It'd be a shame if I fuck it all up, huh?
Probably.
That isn't me. I pushed him a little bit.
That was Marcus.
Fucking designs where you did.
Anyway. Right. Do your forges function any differently than his?
I mean, a forge is a forge, ultimately. It's not going to function excessively different. Where it comes is the quality. The fact that you'll spend less on coals and other such materials to keep your fires burning. And the fact that when people come in, they'll know that you're very serious about your work. You want to be taken serious, don't you?
And suddenly lighting change.
You're welcome, ma'am.
I thought that was my room.
No, the background changed. And how do yours exactly qualify for better quality?
Well, I take longer in making sure that the work is done. I don't leave until the job's
finished.
Taking
longer does not mean that it's better quality. As I'm a bit of a craftsman myself, I can spend an hour on one thing, or 3 hours. It doesn't change the quality on it.
Alright, listen, are you just here to berate me, or are you actually looking to buy?
I'm looking to buy. I just want to know what I'm getting into before I actually make a purchase.
Well, it sounds to me like you really don't want to get the high quality work that I do, and you just want to go with the lesser of the two of us. I'm starting to run out of salesman crap, just so you know.
I'm starting to run out of fucking bullshit customer things as well, so...
Retail in a nutshell!
Oh no, I'm absolutely doing a bunch of red flags that you're not supposed to do in retail right now.
Yeah.
I know.
And I'm just being an ass to the customer,
it's bad employee and bad customer, so...
Asshole customer, I wouldn't say bad customer.
There's a difference.
Yeah, bad customer is one of those people that fucking picks their nose while they're talking to you.
That's
the asshole
is
one that just keeps asking fucking asking questions about the fucking products. Like, hey, do you want it or not, guy? Just like, fucking do it.
Alright, listen. You're clearly not ready to make any kind of investment. So I'll tell you what. You think it over. Come back tomorrow. We'll crunch down some numbers and figure out how much this is all gonna do.
That sounds good to me, though before I take my leave, I have one additional question, and that is, what material do you use for the forge?
Mithril.
Oh, the finest stone that I can get from the dwarven mines. I only take materials locally.
Locally? How is the dwarven mine local?
It's a part of the city.
Oh, you mean that mine, not the, Is there going to be a mine in the home city of dwarves?
Yeah. Technically, technically the entire mine, or the entire mountain, the city, is kind of like all good fantasies where the dwarves mine, and then in the old part of the mine, they build the city as they continue to mine downward.
As per most dwarven lore.
Right.
Damn unoriginal dwarven lore.
I mean, I don't know if it's original or not, but for mine, they have a massive hole that they dig downwards, and then they just make tunnel ways and whatnot around
the rings, Marcus.
Okay, well,
Or Dragon Age.
That too.
I never played Dragon Age, oddly enough.
Or 1,000 other games that involve dwarves.
Basically, all the dwarven cities were connected by tunnels. They were moles.
Oh, that's the Deep Roads thing?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I believe so.
I just thought it was tunnel ways. I didn't realize it actually connected every dwarven city. Or most, or whatever. Anyway.
Unless he has anything else to say, I will thank him for his time and take my leave.
Roll me a strength check real quick.
Wait, me?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're probably gonna pass. Wow, we both rolled a 4.
Eight, because strength bonus, but...
Oh, well, that changed when I put it down, but it was a 4. You can feel he's obviously trying to, in a sense, overpower you with his handshake, and it doesn't last long because then you overpower him. He was trying to show dominance. And you
dominance against a dwarf? What?
I just figured that's what he'll do. And he failed. Horribly. So you head on out. Swapping over then to Tate and Lamb and Noah. Tate, what was Avena's first roll?
Avena's first roll. It was a 16.
That's on the concentration?
Yep.
And then what's the roll for the dice?
D12?
Yeah, it's a D12.
I did not roll that yet. A 5.
If you want, you can adjust that by 3. Right now, you're on an attack. You can either go up to, or down to, that are not attacks. Otherwise, it's strong attack, weak attack, or where you're at right now, which is medium attack. Otherwise,
so
you have...
down to 3.
Yeah, if you go down to a 3.
I would get to find out what those do.
Oh, you don't know what a 3 is yet?
Nope.
Alright. Is that what you want to do?
Yep.
Alright, roll a d6. Do you want to alter this one at all?
Well, I did roll a 17.
Do you want to alter this at all? Do you want to go down to a 1, or do you want to go up to a 6, or where do you want to go?
Going down to a 1.
You want to go down to a 1?
Yes.
All right. It goes down to a 1. On a 3, on the D12, you get to roll a D6. This D6 represents disease.
Oh, Jesus.
And on a one, it's cure all. You and your surrounding individuals, which are only Lamb and Perthros, are cured of all disease. As far as you're aware, any headaches, any cold, any disease, for the most part, is cured.
Oh.
So if you had a migraine, it's gone.
Yay.
Any irritable bowels?
Irritable bowels because of that meat? Well, the bacteria just kind of went bleh. And now you're fine.
Stop shock from seeing a demon come through another portal. Emotional damage. It's cured.
No. It's just disease. So bacteria and viruses. Not emotional trauma. Sorry.
Damn.
As for Lamb, your first roll.
I got resurrect most recently slain adversary.
Okay.
I resurrect one of the villagers.
Yeah, you did. I need to write that down.
Whoa.
You died. Holy shit. That's great.
Just one of the three random villagers I killed with a riot, or with a cone of cold, kinda. Not actually cone of cold, but.
Just like they're gonna go back to town and everyone's dead.
Some of the houses are looted.
Everyone's dead and the houses have been looted.
Do you remember who you might have specifically killed or no?
I killed three people at the same time. That was the only kill I got in that combat.
Was that one of the thugs? Or were they all thugs?
Okay. It was one of the thugs. Base fighter thugs.
All right, Tate, your second roll. Go ahead and roll a d12. Or, Lamb, does your character wish before you guys would realistically continue to go, uh-oh? Because he knows what it was.
Wait, say that again?
Does your character say or do anything? Because he knows what he just cast.
Yes. But it's really kind of vague because of, like, the mood, and I don't want to, like, break shit, so it's a thing we might want to talk about more later. But if you want me to tell you what he says.
Yeah, what does he say?
He's basically saying I want better control of my powers.
No, not anything. When he rezzes a person, does he say anything?
No, not really. It's like, oh. That could be interesting.
Okay.
Hopefully that guy's not mentally scarred forever.
So Tate, go ahead and roll your d12. You can affect it by 3. You know what an 8 is already, I do believe.
I would like to go up to spawn item. 10.
Okay, go ahead and roll that. It's a d12. And it's not spawn item, it's get item. You don't know how you're getting the items.
I rolled a 5.
And you can affect that by 2.
I'd like to bring that up to a 7.
Are you sure you don't want to go to a 6? I think you'll love that.
I've already got a 6.
No, you haven't. You've gotten a 5.
I have. Jar.
Oh, my bad. Yeah. You want to go to a 7, huh?
Yep.
Alright. Before you throw the dice, and where the dice lands suddenly spawns a plate.
Ooh.
Do you pick up the plate?
Pick up the plate.
You pick up the plate, and suddenly, in a sense, growing upon it, suddenly appearing, is a piece of bacon.
God damn it.
Oh.
Do you pick it up?
I do pick up the piece of bacon.
Suddenly, the plate fills with bacon.
Who needs to cook when I have bacon?
It's ready to eat and everything. It's not cold. It is cooked bacon. It is perfect.
Straight up cooked bacon.
It's straight up cooked bacon. It's cooked to a theoretical perfection. Not too crunchy, not too chewy, doesn't taste burnt, doesn't taste uncooked. I don't know what people prefer as their perfect bacon, but that would be the
crispy.
The theoretical middle ground.
I love crispy bacon.
Well, I mean, it's crispy. It's just not like, you know, burnt crispy where it falls literally apart because you burnt it too much. Anyway, the get item, Tate, number 7 is plate of bountiful bacon. It's literally a plate that spawns bacon.
Well, we will need rations now.
Someone get a thesaurus and find another word for plate that starts with B.
I mean, technically, it's got its limit.
We can't just spawn infinite bacon.
Right. But you pick it up, it spawns a piece. You take off a piece, it creates a plate. And you can do that a few times. You guys can easily eat a whole meal of bacon from that thing.
And thus our adventures days ends with heart attacks.
Yeah. Anyway, Lamb, your second one.
That is the 20.
Let's leave that last. What's your third one?
I think also I've actually gotten this one too. It wouldn't mean anything to you. My third one was Ancestral Ultimate Form.
Alright, before both of you guys then, you spawn bacon, Tate, and you go, ooh, you pick it up, do you eat it?
Oh, I try it, yeah, I've got a nibble on it.
Alright, you pick up the one piece, it spawns in a whole bunch of pieces, you nibble on it, you like the taste of it, do you say anything?
I turn to Lamb, look what I made. I cooked food.
And Lamb points the wand outward, which then points itself upward. A beam of light comes down from the sky, slamming upon him, lifting him up into the air. His body jerks back ever so slightly and erupts into light, and he lands onto the ground, now in the form of the ultimate ancestral form. He looks very much like the Metweyo. Well, the white-haired man and the two women with him, he looks like he's part of their race now. And Lamb, you already know what this does to you. Right? You remember?
Isn't it like a +2 to all stats? Something like that.
I believe so. And then, extra magic.
You're looking a little different.
This has happened before. I'll be back. It'll change off in about an hour.
There's just something about his voice that's different. It sounds like you're listening to some sort of person that you would want to be led by.
Oh, it ain't no celestial lion. All right. Well, as long as you're okay. You looked a lot like Akhmenos.
Not Akhmenos.
Not Akhmenos.
You would need, still only know him in a sense as the white-haired man. You do not know that the white-haired man's name is Metweo.
Yeah, Abby never paid attention.
No, because the Celestial Lion said that's who he was looking for. And he said it's a god that lives in your city. And there's only one god that lives in your city. Unless that's what she didn't pay... Oh, that's what you mean she didn't pay attention to. Fair enough, okay.
Staring at other things.
Yeah, at his fucking lion junk, right?
No.
Anyway...
Beautiful mane.
Noah, does Tucson say anything to this plate of bacon or this now more powerful version of lamb?
Noah or talks to the Perthros.
Can I have a piece of bacon, Avina?
Sure, yeah. You know, maybe we should consider with this, if this keeps forever, we have to test it. Maybe we can use... We could sell bacon.
Gonna eat a piece of bacon. I'm gonna grab another one. I'm gonna go hand it to Lamb.
Grab it. Alright, let's see how this one goes.
You can sell bacon at our shop. Oh my god. Charge like 10 copper pieces per bacon.
You know, I kinda want one of those kinds of things. They look fun.
Alright, Tate, make your last roll.
Okay. Eight again.
Well, you can affect that one by 3. So you can go to... Let's see. Attack, race, face, which is what you're on. Do you know what the 9 is yet? Yeah, you know. Limb. Yeah. Get item. And do you know what an 11 is?
Yes.
Okay.
And well, I then. I want to get it up to an 11.
Alright, you do an 11. Make a d12 roll.
Hey, look, a 10. I was kind of hoping for a 12. Second writer's kid again on a rock. Let's have the adventures of Avina.
I gotta look up what this does.
Yay. I love forcing Marcus to look up what things do.
I'm sure you do, Tate. I'm sure you do.
It's like when Cal forces him to make running rolls.
What?
Or movement rolls or whatever.
What?
I mean, craft checks?
Yeah, that too.
It's taking so long to fucking load the page.
D&D wiki?
Yeah.
Not surprised. They've been having some server troubles every once in a while.
Well, the thing is, some other pages were loading totally fine. Oh, maybe it's because my computer's gone to those pages and it just remembers what's on them and whatnot, but whatever. Anyway.
Patching, potentially, but no, some of the pages, or some of the the entire website just loads every once in a while slowly.
All right. Well, in short, I'll tell you what it does here in a minute, but you throw the dice, it lands, and it bounces itself back at you and hits you, activating the ability of the item Cube of Force, which is an item that essentially creates a force field around you. It more or less creates a wall of force 10 feet on a side of a person. Of your person. This cubic screen moves with your character and is impervious to attack forms mentioned on this table below.
And that's when I roll a 10 on the item effect.
Yes. I'm just going to say, for intents and purposes, we're going to go with porpoises. We're going to go with this one. And for 6 minutes, you have a wall of force in front of you that is slowing your movement down to 10 feet, but it keeps out everything. Magic. Living matter, non-living matter, gas, wind, everything.
This sounds like
even oxygen
to me.
Well, he's not like in a box, Des Moines. It's just in front of him.
This sounds like a punishment to me. Like
he's in a glass case of emotion.
Hey, you can't keep up with anybody, and everybody has to stay away from you, which means no hugs. I guess it's a good time to contact my friend.
People can get to you, it's just 10 feet in front of you.
Well, he could always spin around and make himself dizzy.
If you're curious what the Cube of Force is, it's a six-sided dice type of item that when you activate a side, it does something. And it goes as follows. A 1 keeps out gas, wind, etc. A 2 keeps out non-living matter and so forth. A 3 keeps out living matter. A 4 keeps out magic. And a 5 keeps out all things, everything. But it costs more as you go higher up. And then a 6 is it deactivates it and it becomes inert. Nevertheless, Tate, you're impervious to everything technically coming at in front of you. All that stuff that you're not currently in combat to be affected by.
Yay!
I don't want to make a reference, but...
I always wanted to have immunity.
I'm not going to make a reference, but I'm going to make a reference. Tate, you basically you have what Orihime was supposed to fucking have, according to that show's own lore.
You mean the box of, like, don't fuck with me?
No, her wall of I can't be affected, yet it never worked. Anyway... Yep. Back to Lamb. No, we'll wait on that, Lamb.
Gore.
That's all we'll end the night. Kelb, you get back. Arim walks it. Does he go back, I assume?
Yeah.
Okay. He walks in the front door, and it looks like Samael has just about finished up all of his flyers.
Roll to check for spelling mistakes.
Hey, Samuel can spell better than Des Moines.
You should let Abby do the next sign batch.
I can't help but I can't smell them. So.
Do you wish to say anything to each other or no?
I don't see any reason to.
Alright. What do you do when you call, well, when you go in the building there, Kelp?
What is the time of day?
Night. It's after dusk. So realistically, it would be either time to eat and then go sleep, or sleep without eating. Maybe sit around and read a book or something.
I will sit and mess around with the magic book.
Alright. And then, Demoise, what about you?
After finishing the flyers and posting one at, like, on the, like, outside of the guild hall, I will eat and then go to sleep.
What are you gonna eat?
I guess I'll eat rations.
Okay. So you're just eating Chex Mix, basically. Jared, yeah. You've been throwing your knife, and you think it's about time that the book is done.
I'm gonna head up to the balcony and start reading through it.
Okay. So you pick up your books, put the one away, take the other one, go ahead and put yourself on the balcony, and you start to read it. Alright, so you start reading this story, and it starts out saying about just a young man, and the story begins by saying how, or it beginning with how this young man was orphaned as a baby, and that it's not sure what had orphaned him at the time, but luckily for him, a stranger had come along and found him and brought him home and raised him as his own. He seemed to almost always know what the kid was going to do, but not always. Sometimes that little miscreant seemed to get away with stuff. As you're reading this, you start to get a headache, a new feeling for you. And you almost as if begin to image what the book is saying. So much so that you decide, I think I need to put this down for now. While you're reading that though, and putting the book down and getting a headache, because you're like, wow. We'll swap back over to Lamb to finish up the night. Lamb? You point your wand in your now ultimate celestial form upwards to see what it would do one more time. And all of a sudden, this new feeling that comes upon you. And orbs of light suddenly appear around the end of the wand. You let go of it and take a step back as the wand, as the rod hovers in the air with the orbs floating around it. And bursting forth from it is a massive, massive, massive snake dragon.
Of course. One is Popo, 20 is a damn dragon.
I had to.
Yeah, Yeah, I saw it coming.
And he comes out majestically. Swapping over real quick, Jared.
Yep.
Off in the distance, you see some clouds start to form, some lightning, some sort of light coming from the ground, and then this massive dragon. Keep in mind for both, well, everyone has seen it, dragons have been gone for a very long time.
You, the dragon's name be Ronshan?
Maybe. I don't think he's going to give his name.
Damn.
But you see a dragon suddenly, Jared. That book must have really done a number on you. Swapping back, Lamb. The dragon bends itself downward, looking straight at you. And he asks, or he states, I am the Eternal Dragon. What is your wish?
At which point I'm just going to step forward and say, I want better control of my powers. I want better control over what I can do.
His eyes flash and you hear your wish is granted. And he flies upward and flies straight into the rod. And then the rod, after the dragon has finally gone in, absorbs the orbs and falls to the ground.
Well, that was different.
And as you say that, all of a sudden you're kind of hit with some sort of feeling of magic and you pass out.
I like how with my character there's a theme of something happening, me saying something, and then I faint.
Yeah, I've made
like,
it a thing.
Like what, the fourth time?
Yeah, I've made it a thing.
I'm okay.
I don't know, are you doing the bear thing, Lamb?
Yeah. It was like the bear thing, me getting the award, us getting the group award, and this, I think.
Yeah, Ronshin. Anyway, Tate, Noah, what does Avena and Tucson do as they see Perthros just summoned a dragon, asked him to be more powerful. The dragon said, granted, and then he passed out.
First a giant hand, now a dragon. What next?
I'm gonna take out my spare rope. I'm gonna tie his hands and legs together.
And then you're going to put him in the bag of holding?
I think I'm a bit too big for that.
Do you know any shrink spells, Noah?
What do you think I am? A wizard?
A sorcerer.
You could be.
Out of curiosity, why are you tying him up?
Because he's seen Cal go fucking crazy before.
What?
No. Yeah.
Yeah, fair enough.
Not gonna trust him till I know it's him.
Gotcha. Alright, what about you, Tate? You just say your line?
Yep.
Okay.
I think I'm good for now. That's until we get back, but we'll reserve that till next time.
That's how we'll end game.
Alrighty.
I'll need to talk to you more specifically about the wish there, Lamb.
Yeah, that's what I was figuring was going to happen. It's kind of why I kept it vague on purpose.
Okay then.
All right, that's that.